Identified, almost going back on account of lack of electricity, fuel, or other such necessities and logistics to enable relatives to bury their loved. So it's a very serious situation. But what is disturbing for me when I went to, for example, Nyanyatse Bridge, where there was a problem of a blocked passage of the road, there is an effort by police officers to try and clear the road. It tells you that there is no sufficient effort on the part of the state to be able to deal with disaster preparedness, as I indicated, to also be able to deal with the issues of saving lives and rescuing lives, or even averting dangerous situations such as the one we saw. But I must thank the people of Zimbabwe. We've shown that as a people, together and united, we're able to defeat any effects of any disaster. Well wishers, we've managed to contribute changes. This is good for individuals who have come to show love. So it's something that we appreciate, and I must say that on the part of the state, we could do better. We need to see more helicopters, see more deployment of government vehicles and government personnel to help and rescue survivors, and also to help and rescue the burial of the loved ones. So this is something that I will take home and take back to Harare to say, this is not partisan. It's not about politics, it's about our country. We must be able to rise above partisan politics and look at this thing as a national challenge, which must be looked at from a national perspective. Emergent situations require emergent solutions. And I think my coming here together with the leadership of the MDC is our own kind gesture of our willingness to put our heads on the deck to resolve the national challenge.
Your appeal to the corporate world to come in and help and offer a giving hand.
Well, we need a lot, not just an appeal, we also need prayers to our living God. So we are appealing to churches, to through pastors, bishops, apostles and prophets, to also pray for this country, pray for the victims, survivors, also pray for those who are missing their loved ones, so that they find solace and peace. Beyond that, business people, corporate world, the international community, within the region, SADC, the AU, and of course, the international community in the West, may they come to the rescue of Zimbabwe and help the people of Zimbabwe. Together we are able to deal with this. This is a natural disaster, it's not man-made. So we need to have a collective and concerted effort to try. In terms of Mr. Mnangagwa, yes, I think he is getting it the wrong way. When you have such a crisis of this magnitude, you can't afford to even travel. Even to call it a short stay, a short visit, it was not necessary. Even to cut it short is ill-advised. You don't cut short something that was short. He was not supposed to travel in the first place as a demonstration of your seriousness. He was supposed to be here, you know, supervising, being on the ground, seeing how the situation was being sorted. Of course, he can't be on the ground to do the handwork, but he was supposed to be here to provide leadership, motivation, inspiration, comfort, and direction to the ordinary people.
Well, Mr. President, on the issue of preparedness.
Good thing in the beginning. I'm jealous, my cousin. I'm jealous.